In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP lumbar spine. The AP lumbar spine should be performed with the patient lying on the table. With 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. I am starting with the IR in the bucky tray, so you will need to make sure that all of your locks are engaged. I am also choosing not to shield on this particular exam because it would obscure diagnostic information. We're going to start here with the IR in the bucky tray, and I am going to center at the crest. It will vary from patient to patient and the IR that you use, whether you center at the crest or an inch and a half above the level of the crest. You want to use the mid-sagittal plane. We're going to keep that collimation open lengthwise and collimate about 2 inches from side to side. We're going to have our patient bend her knees to reduce that lordotic arch. Okay. We are going to use a respiration of exhale and then hold their breath and suspend. We're going to use a right marker over here on the right side. And the patient will hold very still and the exposure is made. A diagnostic AP lumbar spine radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include the open intervertebral disc spaces. Visualization of 5 lumbar vertebrae to include T12 and sacrum. Spinous process is centered to the bodies with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP lumbar spine, the left posterior oblique. The AP lumbar spine, LPO view, should be performed with the patient lying on the table. With a 40-inch source to image distance and no tube angulation. I'm going to have you take this hand and touch over there. I'm going to have you bend this knee and again control your patient's movement by the shoulder and the hip and roll her up uniformly. And we're going to use that angle sponge again to immobilize that 45 degrees. We're going to use those same landmarks either at the crest or an inch and a half above and then 2 inches medial to the ASIS. Okay. This time she's rowed to the left, so I'm going to use a left marker over here on the left side. We again will see the Scotty dogs and the breathing instructions are still the same. So patient, please take in a big deep breath and blow your breath all the way out. Hold your breath, don't breathe, don't move, and the exposure is taken. A diagnostic AP lumbar spine left posterior oblique, LPO view, radiograph must be free of motion. Demonstrated anatomy to include T12, 5 lumbar vertebrae, and the sacrum. The zygapophyseal joints closest to the image receptor. The appearance of the Scotty dogs and proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP lumbar spine right posterior oblique. The AP lumbar spine, RPO view, should be performed with the patient lying on the table. With a 40-inch source to image distance and no tube angulation. The next view I will do is the right posterior oblique. So the patient will row towards me 45 degrees. So I'm going to have her stretch her legs out, stretch both of them out. We're going to have you take this hand and touch over here on this shoulder, and I'm going to have you bend this knee. And I'm going to control her movement so that she rolls uniformly. I'm going to take her shoulder and her hip, and I'm going to roll her like a log up 45 degrees. I'm going to use a 45 degree angle sponge. It helps immobilize the patient, and it also ensures me that I'm at 45 degrees. All right, I'm going to make sure her elbow is out of the field of view, and I'm going to use her crest again, and I'm going to center an inch and a half above or at the crest, and then we're going to center 2 inches medially to the ASIS. This is rolled to the right, so I will use the right marker here indicating the RPO. You will see the Scotty dogs on this particular view, and you definitely want your patient to exhale. That raises up the diaphragm so we can see the lumbar spine much better. So the patient, take in a big breath and blow your breath all the way out. Now hold your breath, don't breathe. A diagnostic AP lumbar spine right posterior oblique RPO view, radiograph must be free of motion. Demonstrated anatomy to include T12, 5 lumbar vertebrae, and the sacrum, the zygapophyseal joints closest to the image receptor, the appearance of Scotty dogs, and proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the lateral lumbar spine. The lateral lumbar spine should be performed with the patient lying on the table with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no-tube angulation. Now I'm going to have you keep rolling all the way up to your left side. Again, we want to make sure that our patient is in true lateral position, so we want to make sure the shoulders are stacked, the hips, knees, and ankles. We're going to push her forward to make sure that her back is very straight. Your arms are right here in front of your face, and we're going to keep that back really nice and straight. Our central ray here is at the crest, or again, an inch and a half above. We're using the coronal plane. She's on her left side, so I'm going to use that left marker right here anteriorly, and we're going to have her exhale. So be patient, please take a big deep breath. And blow your breath all the way out and stop breathing, hold your breath. A diagnostic lateral lumbar spine radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include from the 12th thoracic vertebrae to the sacrum, open intervertebral disc spaces and intervertebral foramina from L1 to L4. The spinous processes in profile with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the lateral L5-S1 of the lumbar spine. The L5-S1 of the lumbar spine should be performed with the patient lying on the table with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and a 5 to 8 degree caudal tube angulation, depending on sex or body habitus. So the last view is a spot film of L5-S1, the lower lumbar and the first sacral area. So we're going to utilize an angle on this, and it is 5 to 8 degree caudal tube angulation, depending on sex or body habitus. Make sure that your IR is still centered after you have included the angle. Our central ray is an inch and a half inferior to the crest, and then it's 2 inches posterior to the ASIS. It's a tight collimation of that joint space. Again, we're going to use the left marker anteriorly. And I still am going to have the patient exhale, and she's going to hold very still. Please take in a big deep breath and blow your breath all the way out and hold your breath. A diagnostic L5-S1 lumbar spot of the lumbar spine radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include open lumbosacral intervertebral disc spaces with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.